All right, crew, welcome to our social studies lesson. As a reminder, you need to take your assessment if you haven't already taken it for the Colonial America packet. You can use your packet on the test. So if it asks a question, you can look up the answer in your packet. All right, our new unit is going to be American Revolution. It says one there because this is the first part of the American Revolution. We will have a different one for the next part. So I just wanted to go over some stuff in this with you. So the first page looks like this, and it says American Revolution number one. In this unit, you will learn about the causes and the beginnings of the American Revolution. This graphic organizer will introduce you to some of the things you will learn. So it just has a list here of cause and effects. So British expansion, the effect from that was conflict with French, which then led to the French and Indian War, which led to British war debt, which led to the Stamp Act, which led to Sons of Liberty, which led to the repeal of the Stamp Act, which led to continued war debt. Then that led to the Townshend Acts, which led to boycotts, which led to increased tension, which led to the Boston Massacre, which led to rising tension, continued war debt. That turned into the Tea Act. Then that became the Boston Tea Party. From there, that gave us the Intolerable Acts, the Committee of Correspondence, and the First Continental Congress. So those are all cause and effects that eventually led us to war with Britain to declare our independence. So let's look at some vocabulary words that we're going to run into in this unit. Our first one is backcountry, and that is land that was close to the Appalachian Mountains in the colonial days. Boycott is to refuse to buy something in order to express disapproval or create change. Fort is a small, strong building to protect soldiers. Intolerable is unacceptable. Militia is a volunteer army. Parliament is a group of elected British lawmakers. Protest is to speak out against something. Repeal is to take back. Surplus in business, how much you have of something that still needs to be sold. And then last is a tariff, which is a tax on imported goods. Okay, so let's talk about the French and Indian War. So that's a brief one. I'm going to just go ahead and I'm going to read it to you, and then we'll discuss what you guys need to do. So the focus of this is that the British, the French, and the Native Americans fought for control over the Ohio River Valley. So in the 1700s, the 13 British colonies in North America were booming. As population grew, land in those colonies became more and more expensive. Many colonists began to move west. They moved to the backcountry. The backcountry was land that was close to the Appalachian Mountains in the colonial days. The colonists settled the land. They built log cabins, they farmed and hunted. Ohio River Valley. In the mid-1700s, colonists moved even farther west. They moved into an area called the Ohio River Valley. The Ohio River Valley is the rich and fertile land that borders the Ohio River. This area was also dense with trees. Colonists who moved to this area created a big problem. There were already large populations of Indians living on this land. These Native Americans have been living there for thousands and thousands of years. They did not want the colonists to live on their land. French claims to the Ohio River Valley. There was another problem. The French said that the Ohio River Valley belonged to them. Frenchman Robert LaSalle explored this area in 1682. He claimed the Mississippi River for the French Empire. He also said that all of the tributaries of the Mississippi River, including the Ohio River, belonged to France. The French and the British built many forts in this area to defend the Ohio River Valley. A fort is a small, strong building for soldiers. And that's a picture of what a fort would look like. Okay, let's turn the page now, page 78. The conflict. In 1754, war broke out between the British, the French, and the Native Americans. They fought over who would control the Ohio River Valley. This conflict was called the French and Indian War. The French and many of the Indian tribes fought together against the British. The war lasted for 7 years. The 7 years refers to the time that elapsed between the declaration of war and the signing of the peace treaty, not the years of actual fighting. Winning the war. Colonel George Washington fought and led troops in the conflict when he was 21 years old. Washington led 150 men to try and capture the French Fort Duquesne. They were unsuccessful. For a time, it looked as if the British would lose the war. But in 1758, the British began winning battles, and in 1759, the Iroquois Nation fought with the British against the French. They believed this would help them hold on to their land. In 1759, British General James Wolfe captured Quebec. Quebec was an important city in the colony of New France in Canada. The capture of Quebec helped the British defeat the French. The British and the French signed the Treaty of Paris in 1763. This officially ended the war. That's important to note because it'll lead to other things later. So the importance of the French and Indian War. The French and Indian War was very important. It had a big impact because Britain gained more land in North America. Britain got control of land that belonged to Native Americans. And Britain imposed taxes on the colonists to pay for the war. Anger over these taxes fueled the American Revolution. So right there, we can see the cause and effect. Because the British had so much debt from that war, they taxed the colonists to pay for it. Okay? So what you're going to do today is first you have a timeline that looks like this in your bags. You need to fill it in. The one date that I didn't add to this that I should have was that the French and British signed the Treaty of Paris in 1763. So I'm just going to put that on the bottom. I'm going to write 1763 Treaty of Paris was signed to end the war. So I colored in my picture. You definitely don't have to if you don't want to. So you can go ahead and pause the video right here and fill in your timeline. I want you guys to do this so that you remember these dates. This war is very important because it's ultimately what led to us fighting against Britain to get our independence. One more thing that you guys need to do from this brief is research the different Native American tribes that fought in this war. You can pick one tribe. I did mention the Iroquois in there. There was more tribes than that fought in this war. So you can Google tribes that fought in the French and Indian War. Pick one of those tribes and write me a paragraph about them. I would like this turned in as a Google Doc. I'm going to be sharing a video on how to do Google Docs for those of you who don't know how. This would be the preferred way for you guys to start turning in your paragraphs so that I can grade them more quickly. If you have any questions about this assignment, let me know. Thanks, guys.